Hey guys, today is our topic about the fertilization. Fertilization, it is the fusion of the male and the female gametes. Male gamete is the sperm and the female gamete is the ovum. Fertilization occurs in the ampulla region of the fallopian tube. So when the sperm and ovum will come at the ampulla region, then the fertilization will occur. So we will, first of all, we will discuss about the ovum, that how ovum reach at the ampulla region of the fallopian tube. This one is ovary. In the ovary, the main function of the ovary is to produce of the ovum. When the ovum is produced, the structure of the ovum have the cells outside the membrane. These cells are called the corona radiata cells. And the layer, this layer is called the zona pellucida. And this one is oocyte membrane. This whole one is cytoplasm. And this one is nucleus of the ovum. So this structure is called the fimbriae. When the ovum is produced in the evolution process at the 14 days of the evolutionary process, when the ovum produced, then the two hormones level is high, which is name is the follicle stimulating hormone is the luteinizing hormone. Two hormone level is high. First one is follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone level is high when the ovum is produced. When the ovum is produced, for example, there is a ovum. This fimbriae like structure, this is a cilia like structure. This release some chemicals, and these chemicals capture the ovum, and then ovum will enter to this part of the fallopian tube. And this part of the fallopian tube is called the infundibulum. As we know, fertilization occurs at the ampulla region of the fallopian tube, and ovum is non-motile. Then how is that possible that ovum will reach at the ampulla region of the fallopian tube? For this, we should know that fallopian tube is made up of the ciliated columnar epithelial cells. So this cilia-like structure help the movement of the ovum. And reach the ovum to the ampulla region of the fallopian tube. Why fertilization occurs at the ampulla region of the fallopian tube? The reason is this, that this region of the fallopian tube is wide and the broad, so that the fertilization occurs into the ampulla region of the fallopian tube. This was the mechanism that how ovum reach at the site of the fertilization, mean at the ampulla. Now we will discuss about the sperm. At the time of the ejaculation, in one time of the ejaculation, 200 to 500 million sperms are ejaculated. How many sperms? 200 to 500 million sperms. 200 to 500 million sperms are ejaculated in one ejaculation period. When these sperm were released and in one ejaculation, the 10% of the semen is made up of the sperm. How many? Only 10% is the semen, sperm, sorry. 10% sperm. Sperm will be ejaculated into the vagina. Then how these sperm will reach at the site of the fertilization, mean to the ampulla region? Now we will discuss about the sperm, that how it's reached to the ampulla region. If we know the composition of the sperm, is fructose, protein, amino acids. It's also having the enzyme which is known as a vesiculase enzyme. And if I write here, composition of the sperm is fructose, protein, amino acid, vesiculase enzyme, fibrinolysis. These are
chemicals like zinc also present into the sperm.
So when the sperm is ejaculated here into vagina, millions of the sperms are ejaculated into vagina, and some sperms will come out from the vagina. Why? Because there is present of the vesiculase enzyme. What's function of the vesiculase enzyme? Vesiculase enzyme cause the coagulation of these sperms, attachment of the sperm with the vagina layer wall or the cervix wall. This vesiculase enzyme cause the coagulation of the sperm with vaginal wall or the cervical wall. Sperms which will not attach with this layer, then they will come out through the vagina. There's also present of the fibrinolysis. Fibrinolysis cause the detachment of these sperms, and then these sperm will move upward through the vagina toward the fallopian tube. It also consists of the citric acids. Into the vagina, we know that the sperm is the motile in nature, but the movement of the sperm into vagina is less. It is less motile. Why in the vagina the sperm is less motile? The reason is that vagina is an acidic medium in nature. Vagina acidic in nature. But when the sperm will move upward and here will reach to the uterus, then they are the more motile. Why the sperm are more motile in the uterus? Because that the uterus is the alkaline in nature. And sperm will reach to the fallopian tube. How sperm will reach to the fallopian tube? For this purpose, we should know about the structure of the sperm. For example, if I draw here the structure of the sperm, this one, for simply. Here is the acrosome, head of the acrosome. This one is midpiece, is called the mitochondria. Is present of the mitochondria. This one is tail, which is made up of the flagella like structure. This mitochondria provide the ATP, so this sperm will move upward. And there's also present of the fructose, provide the nutrition to this sperm, so this sperm will move upward. Why the sperm will move upward? The two reason that the main, it there's present of the nutrition. One is the fructose will provide the nutrition to the sperm, so the sperm will move upward. And there's also present of the mitochondria in the middle piece of the sperm. Mitochondria also provide the energy to the sperm, so sperm will move upward. So when the sperm will reach near to the fallopian tube, some sperm reach near to the fallopian tube, but they don't reach the site of the ampullar region of the fallopian tube. Because the reason is this, we know that fallopian tube is made up of the cilia. And when the sperm will move, this ciliated-like structure will trap the sperm, and they cause the death of the sperm. And when the sperm will reach at the site of the fallopian tube, then this ovum release some chemicals. These chemicals are the chemoattractive agents.
So these chemicals cause the attraction of these sperms toward the ovum. And when this sperm will reach near to the ovum and at the site of the fertilization fallopian tube, then what's happened here? We will discuss here. And the most healthy sperms, the most healthy sperm reach at the site of the fallopian tube into the 5 minutes. Some sperm reach to the site of the fertilization or to the impula region of the fallopian tube nearly over the 45 to 50 minutes. And when they take here, then the fusion will occur and then fertilization will be occur here. And what's
this
happened
one is
here?
A sperm, the head of the sperm is consist of the proteoglycan or glycoprotein. There is also present of the lipid cholesterol, but in this way the sperm can't act or the can't fuse with the ovum. And for the fertilization or the fusion of this sperm, we need to clean off this glycoprotein and the cholesterol. When this glycoprotein and the cholesterol will be cleared, when this glycoprotein and cholesterol will be cleared, then this sperm can attack or the can attach with the zona pellucida layer of the ovum, and then the sperm will be like this when this one is clean. And this process is called the capacitation. This is called the capacitation. Capacitation is the process in which the glycoprotein and the cholesterol are cleared from the head of the sperm. This is called the capacitation. And in this way, the sperm is more motile in nature, cause the more motility. Capacitation cause the more motility of the sperm. So when the sperm will reach at to the zona pellucida, will attach here, there's present of the specific receptors, which name is a ZP3. When it's attached with the zona pellucida, there's in cause to the acrosomal reaction. In this, the acrosome of the head release some chemicals. The name of the chemicals from the acrosome is the, for example, there's enzyme. These enzyme are the acrosine, trypsin, hyaluronic acid. When these enzyme will act on the corona radiata with the ZP3, then this reaction is called the acrosomal reaction. And at the last one, this one is the membrane of the oocyte membrane. When the sperm will reach at the oocyte membrane, then it's caused to form a aperch. What mean of the aperch? Mean that the acrosome of the head will be removed. Then the structure of the sperm will be like this one. This one head will be removed, and only the structure of the sperm will be like this one. This one is the nucleus, and when we'll reach there's here's caused to the influx of the sodium ion. There's also this one is a cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, there's present of the specific granules, which name is the cortical granules. These granules cause to the entry of the first sperm into the cytoplasm of the ovum. Then this cause the impermeability for the other sperms, because then other sperm can't enter to the cytoplasm of the ovum, and only one sperm can enter, and then all the sperm will degenerate or die. And this present of the protein, which name is a disintegrin. Disintegrin here's in the sperm and the integrin protein in the ovum. When the integrin and the disintegrin protein like structure attach with each other, then this genetic material will enter to the ovum. This
material will enter to the ovum, and this genetic material of the ovum and sperm will fuse with each other, and this process is called the fertilization. Hope so you understand that disintegrating of the sperm and the integrin of the ovum will attach, and only the genetic material of the sperm will enter to the ovum genetic material, and this process is called the fertilization. And after all, there is the present of the process will start of the cleavage, then blastocytes, then all the pregnancy process will be occurred. So this was the totally about the